Hi there, this is Fateh, and today we're going to be having a straight-to-the-point Figma tutorial. I'm going to show you how to exactly use a simple plugin in order to simulate the responsiveness of your prototypes. This comes handy if you want to see how your design reacts to breakpoints, or maybe to show them to your client and hand them off to your devs. Now, what's a breakpoint? In responsive design, a breakpoint is the point at which a website's content will adapt in a certain way in order to provide the best user experience possible. Users can visit your website on different screens. It could be mobile, tablet, desktop, or in some cases, very wide screens. Therefore, it's essential that your web design is responsive across all devices. Now we're going to see all this in action using a simple Figma plugin called Responsive. Let's dive into it. Here I have some quick wireframes in Figma that I've already created, nothing too fancy, just to simulate the content. And here we have them filled with pictures and text, so you can clearly see Figma's image fill property working in real time. So, first of all, do your things, create your design like you normally would. Convert them into mobile, tablet, desktop, and widescreen. Name your frames so you can recognize them. When you're done, search for the responsive plugin and run it. Select all your responsive frames and add them to the input frames by clicking on this button. Create a responsive frame. Assign it to the plugin using this button. That's all you had to do. Your breakpoints are ready and we're gonna test them right away. I made that scale for me to see my breakpoints. And we're gonna resize our frame to see the design getting adapted to the variation of the screens. Of course, at a certain point, on wider screens, the design needs to be centered and we don't want it to stretch anymore. To do that, go to the larger frame and choose fixed width. That's gonna be all for today. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. Activate the bell to get notified when I upload my next tutorial. Let me know in the comments if you liked it, and tell me what's the best Figma plugin for you out there. Until then, take care. I'll see you next time.